This is Rock and Roll is supported by the Just Nuts Music School. Learn and play music every day. And also Manhattan Beer Distributors, the leading distributor of party beverages in the Bronx. On this episode of This is Rock and Roll, we interview Eddie Denise, where he speaks of his upcoming and joining Dion's band.
Dixie Dregs, The Little Fiend, that kind of music. But it was really where I learned to hone my trade live there. I could just watch other bass players and watch.
So sit back, relax, because this is Rock and Roll.
Everybody, welcome back to This is Rock and Roll. We just heard the Just Nuts band, and now from WBOX Radio, we have Mr. Dennis Dion Nardone.
And once again, I want to say thank you to Mary, looking beautiful, for introducing me to once again another edition of This is Rock and Roll. My name is Dennis Dion Nardone, and tonight's guest. Very special guest, a great, great entertainer, and a great performer. And I have to say hello to Mr. Eddie Denise. Hello, Eddie. Welcome to This is Rock and Roll.
Thanks so much for having me. I appreciate it.
And, boy, I tell you, you are one of the finest bass players on the East Coast.
I appreciate that.
Yes, yes, yes. So anyway, you know, happy to have you here. Been longing for a long time to get you down to the radio show. And of course, I've seen you perform for a few years, of course, with our good friend from the Bronx, Dion. And we're going to talk about that as we go on. But Eddie Denise, you play the bass guitar. You play other instruments as well?
Well, I sing, of course, and I actually started on regular six-string guitar. Mm. And then during my teenage years in a garage band, the bass player quit and someone had to do it, and the rest is history.
All right, Eddie, let's start from the beginning. Where are you from?
Originally born in Yonkers, New York, right near Getty Square. And then moved to Mount Vernon, New York, and eventually graduated from Mount Vernon High School a million years ago.
Did you play basketball in Mount Vernon? Any sports?
I was vertically challenged for that.
Yes. All right, so you find yourself in Mount Vernon, and like myself, we're about the same age. I might be a little older, but back then, a lot of garage bands, the Beatles were all over the place, and all this kind of great music going on. Everyone was picking up guitars and everything else. How did you start in the business?
Basically, I was about 9 years old when I started taking guitar lessons, and about 12 or 13, garage band, and started playing in various...
Were you like festivals. All of us? You seen the Beatles on TV, said, I gotta get me a guitar.
Well, fortunately, by the time they came of age, you know, I was already playing guitar, and I found out that girls would pay attention to me if I played Beatles songs, so that helped.
So you played in garage bands during high school?
Absolutely.
And do you remember your first band and the way you were playing?
Yeah, my first band was called the Sunbeams. I was 13 years old, and instead of saying, hey, hey, we're the Monkees, we sang, hey, hey, we're the Sunbeams.
Oh, okay.
And adapted the lyrics accordingly.
And oh, by the way, you met Mary. We have one of our rock and roll cups. I'm going to ask Mary to bring one out for you. We'd like to give it to each one of our guests.
Right.
And she's going to bring out a cup for you.
Hi, Eddie.
A little token of our appreciation for coming on the show.
That's very cool.
Yeah, so...
she has great shoes, by the way.
Yeah, we got to show those shoes later. But anyway, okay, so now you're back in high school, Mount Vernon. You're playing in different clubs. Like when I was doing back then, we played a lot of the beach clubs around New Rochelle. Oh. And, of course... a few clubs started to pop up here and there, and so you turned to the bass, and that's what you got your niche on with the bass guitar?
Absolutely, and then eventually, you know, started playing in clubs like the Crazy Horse Cafe, owned by one Vincent Pastor.
Who we had on the guest. Mm-hmm. Who was, by the way, my cousin. We did the radio show.
That's right.
When I was doing a radio show with Vinny, and you came down to WVOX.
Right.
So you played the Crazy Horse.
Right.
A lot of rock and roll there back then.
Absolutely.
You must have been in a different band back
then. Yeah, I was in a band called Sidewinder, and then a band called the Hip Pocket Band.
Mm-hmm.
Did a lot of like Dixie Dregs, a Little Feet, that kind of music.
Mm-hmm.
But it was really where I learned my trade. I learned to hone my trade a lot. Mm-hmm. I would just watch other bass players and watch what they did.
Yeah. We are speaking to Eddie Denise right now. He is the bass player for Dion DiMucci's band. But we started talking about his growing up in the Westchester area. And now, let's go back now. We're out in the 60s, we're in the 70s. You played disco? Well, let's go backwards first. What was it? You playing, of course, classic rock then, Stones,
yeah,
all that type of stuff?
Stones Mountain was probably my favorite. Felix Pappalardi from the Bronx was a mentor of mine. I wanted to be the next him, but that didn't quite work out either.
Right. Yeah, so you're a big Mountain fan.
Big Mountain fan, classic rock. And then, of course, you know, going through the 80s, learning to play disco, the 70s and 80s playing disco, you do what you have. You did what you have to do to work.
And
I could sing, so I could get work.
Yeah. So did you like the disco era, or you were like some of us saying, oh man, what's happened to my Stones and Beatles, and everything switching back and forth, or you didn't mind?
I liked it because the bass player really had to work hard. You know, it really had to get those octaves down, and you know, even the dance music like Stevie Wonder and the funk Ohio Players, that was a great time for bass players.
About Boogie Oogie.
Great line. I'm sorry, it's a great bass line.
Right. Okay, so we're moving out of the disco. What was the name of the bands? Do you remember before the disco era? Did you get dressed up in a disco type of music?
It was more, at that point, I was more getting into the wedding thing,
mm-hmm.
you know, and brass tacks and, you know, elegant ensembles and stuff like that.
Yeah. How did you find out you could sing all of a sudden? Just got behind a microphone and said, man, we're sounding good.
I'd like to think I was actually born a singer.
Mm-hmm.
And then just learned how to play an instrument.
Right.
So singing and playing guitar wasn't a problem, but the bigger challenge was singing and playing bass. And since I could do that, that really opened up a lot of venues and bookings for me.
Now, speaking to Eddie Denise here, playing with Dion now, you just mentioned Vinny Pastor. You played in his band now, don't you? He has his...
The Gangster Squad.
The Gangster Squad. You with him and Charlie Powers on drums.
That's correct. Frank Bazzani on keyboards, having a good time.
You play a lot down in New York City now, right?
New York City, there's the resort casino out near Kennedy Airport, and sometimes it's down by Asbury Park.
And who does most of the singing there?
We switch it around. Vinny does his thing.
Yeah.
And then I'll sing a little bit, and then Charlie Powers will sing, then Pizzani will sing. So, you know, it makes it interesting by switching it around.
All right. Now, how did you end up get hooked up with Dion? I mean, I go to a show,
mm-hmm.
and I'm sitting there, and there you are on stage. This is going back 2 years. I'm saying, that's Eddie Denise.
Yeah.
So how'd that all happen?
My great friend, Dennis DeBrisi.
Okay.
I had known him for a few years and played in a couple of bands.
Who's the keyboard player?
Keyboard player.
Who was with the Regents for so many years. And he's from the Bronx.
And originally, Dennis got me with the Shangri-Las.
Oh, okay.
You know, I did a few of those. And then Dennis asked me one day, can you read music? And I said, yes. I started playing with Luke Christie, which is a lot of fun.
Yeah.
You know, it's a great book to play. And then Dennis one day said, listen, Dion's looking to make a change in the bass chair. Are you interested?
Mm-hmm.
It's like saying, do I like breathing? You know,
So you mentioned you read music.
Yes.
Did you study music when you were younger? We missed that part. You went to school?
I did go to music school. I learned how to read guitar first.
Uh-huh.
And then eventually, when I switched over to bass, I didn't learn to read bass right away, but when it came time to learn how to read it, I just knuckled down and learned how to read it.
Okay. All right, I think we have a video of you and Dion's band.
Okay.
And I believe this is at Westbury, Long Island. And
one place.
You'll see me in the front row. If you look hard enough, you'll see me with a blue shirt. And this is the end of the show, of course. Always a big finale. Mm-hmm. It's always the best part of the show. Everybody waits for that wanderer, that runaround shoe. How's it feel when you... hold that note. Let's go to the video,
okay,
and then we'll talk about that. Let the people feel the energy
okay
of it. So let's go to the video. Watch the monitor. Here you'll see my man on stage with Dion playing the bass. And of course, with the crowd going crazy. Let's take a look. Welcome back. My name is Denise Dion Nardone, and that's a video, and that's a clip of our good friend from the Bronx, New York, king of the New York streets, Dion DiMucci, and our guest is his bass player, bass guitarist, Eddie Denise. Eddie, the energy, the excitement on stage when you're playing with Dion and the crowd just goes nuts to the wander and run around, Sue. I mean, it's just... tell me the feeling.
Well, it's, as you said, it's the culmination of the show, the climax of the show, and playing his music. He does put on a couple of new tunes, but he plays the classics that everyone came to see. And when we get to that point of the show, and the audience just stands up, it's like, now it's just a party. Yeah. Now everyone's in on the party, you know, and we're going to have a good time and take this thing out.
Yeah,
that's what it's like.
And after all these years, it always appears he feels it too, you know.
Absolutely.
During the show, he likes to play his little guitar part and the little blues and show his other talents.
Yeah.
And like you said, he sings his other songs that people want to hear. He's got to sing Donna, you know, and a few others. Mm-hmm. Teenager in Love. But when you come to that end and that finale, it's just amazing. And it's great to be part of it.
You got
to be excited.
He feeds off that energy. You could just see it.
Yeah.
You know? The way he just moves around and waves his arms.
So you sing background with the band as well.
I do.
And you have a favorite Dion song at all?
I'd have to say Abraham, Martin, and John.
Really?
I just love that song. It's just, he was in transition in that part of his life. And first of all, I love it all. You have to understand, I'm playing with one of my heroes. Growing up, I loved this music. To get a chance to play with him, what a blessing. I mean, how blessed am I? But that song just, it just moves me. And you could tell the crowd gets very solemn during that song.
Yeah.
And the visions of the presidents and Bobby Kennedy.
And they showed a video of the presidents. Yeah, it's a great mixture of Dion's show.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, Dion's going to be 80. We got anything planned for his big bash? How about closing down the Bronx, Arthur Avenue, and bring Dion on? What do you think?
Dean, do you hear that, Dean? I would love to do that. Fortune Beats, I don't care. That'd be a great idea. It would.
Yeah.
But he's as young as he feels, and, you know, it's great.
Now, we mentioned Vinny Pastor, we mentioned Dion. Didn't you play once in a while with the other guitarist from the Bronx, Curtin?
Oh, Timmy Curtin?
Absolutely.
My boy, Tim.
Yeah,
he used to be with Pig Vomit.
Pig Vomit of the Howard Stern Show, right?
Howard Stern Show, and Timmy is just a gentleman, a scholar, a great player, and he's a nice guy.
Now, I've never seen him, but I hear he's a great guitar player himself.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Very knowledgeable, very studied, and yet very organic and natural at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Good guy.
Yeah. So now you have any own recordings, Eddie Denise? Can we use a? You have a website? You have Eddie Denise?
I do. EddieDenise.com. My son and I have a duo called Set to Stun.
Say that again.
Set to Stun. Set to Stun, like a stun gun.
Oh, okay.
And my son JD and I, we recorded it a few years ago.
He sings, plays.
He plays percussion. He sings. You can find the songs on iTunes. And I've written all the songs. I'm also a songwriter.
Oh, okay.
So, and I'm not a bad cook either.
Bad cook?
I'm an okay cook.
Yeah? What do you like to cook?
Oh, I love that.
Oh, I hope it's pasta.
Oh, eggplant parmesan.
Really?
Forget about it.
Yeah, sausage and peppers too?
Hey.
You cook for Dion?
The best is when we have cannolis after a Dion show.
Oh, I can tell you
from
stories.
From Arthur
Avenue. You know, I was Tropicana, Atlantic City.
Yeah.
I was backstage.
Yeah.
And he calls me over and starts, here I am backstage with Dion, and he's telling me to make cannolis with him.
I was there, you made it for me.
I'm trying to squeeze. He said, come on, just squeeze. I'm all excited. Hey. Yeah. Anyway, it's another story. And backstage is great with Dion.
Absolutely.
And, of course, everybody kind of got to come back to say hello.
Yeah.
And so it's a great time. And besides the fact, you're a great performer with Dion, and you really add to the show. Who else is in the band? Mention some of the names.
We got Al Carosi, who is the musical director. He's from Jersey. He's on guitar. Gary Weiss on drums, left-handed drummer. Son of Thunder, Dennis DeBreezy, you know. The what does he call him? The King of Common Sense.
Yeah. I like when Dion called Gary the captain of the Staten Island Ferry.
And of course, Arno Hecht, Arno.
And he has a nickname for you, Dion.
Oh, the Lowrider.
The Lowrider.
Because of my Harley riding.
And since we brought that up, he played that song on the Fallon show, Jimmy Fallon show.
Ride With You.
Right, Ride With You, which is every time he plays in a concert, he mentions you.
Right.
With the Lowrider and this and that. You're a bike rider?
I am.
Oh, okay, I guess that makes
40
sense.
Years now, yeah.
Okay, so Jimmy Fallon, you got on Jimmy Fallon nationwide TV.
Yeah.
Now you reached the top here. First you were Dion, now you're on nationwide TV.
Yeah.
How does that